Today's comment picked was from MCRSRM. He says, how do you customize the tool palette with your blocks? I would really like to set one up so I don't have to search my CAD files for the blocks I always use. Don't forget to hit that subscribe and bell buttons and leave your topic for my next tutorials on the comments. When reaching 20 topics on this video, the lazy Arquitecto will pick one and do it. AutoCAD Tool Palettes. In order to give this tutorial a better organization, I'll divide this video in 4 questions. Question 1. Why should we even care about tool palettes? Reason 1. Your blocks always will be available for you. Reason 2. Any objects from the tool palette always will come with the correct layer. Reason 3. Tool palette is not just blocks. You can add commands, dimensions, system variables, text, line types, hatches, and the list goes on and on. Reason 4. To summarize, learn tool palette and enhance your productivity. Let me give you some examples. Tool palette and hatches. They come in their specific layer, their specific hatch pattern. Tool palettes and text. They come in their own layers. In their own text heights. They can come even in their own text style. Tool palette and line types. They come in their own layers, in their own line type style, even in their own line type scale. Tool palettes and dimensions. Again, they come in their own layers. In their own dim style. Tool palettes and system variables. Tool palettes and blocks. Again, they're coming their own layers. Tool palette and commands. Just subscribe. Now that you saw tool palette's power, let's go to the next question. Be aware, this is an advanced AutoCAD tutorial. If you are totally new to this video topic, I suggest you to check one of my partner's videos below on the video description, and then come back. Question 2. How do we add all of these productive tools to our tool palette? For hatches, we just click and drag the hatch to the tool palette. Then we can rename it. Again, the same process, click or right click and drag it. Since I don't need them because I have it, I can click and delete them. We add text in the following way. Before, let's see what happens if I just drag this text to the tool palette. As you can see, that's not what we want. The secret here is first, make the text blocked and then drag it to the tool palette. Then you will change some settings in order to explode that block at the same time that you insert it. I'll explain properties in a while. We add blocks in our tool palette just the same way as we add the hatches, click and drag. We add line types in a similar way, selecting it, click and drag. Select, right click and drag, and then we can rename it. We add dimensions by selecting it, right click and drag it. Select, right click and drag it. We add system variables to our tool palette in the following way. The secret here is to create a rectangle or polyline and then click and drag it to the tool palette. Then go to properties and change use flyout to no. And then we can type the system variable in this rectangle. In this case, I'll use wipeout frame system variable. Set that to 1 since that will turn wipeout frame on, and I'll name it. I'll copy this to create wipeout frame off. And I'll change 1 to 0 since that is the settings to turn wipeout frame off. By the way, if you want the Lazy Arquitecto release a video on how to do wipeouts for real circles and arcs, help us reach 100 likes on this video. We add commands in the following way by going to properties and select customize commands. In this case, I'll add the zoom extend command. I'll click and drag it to the tool palette. Oops. Jesus Christ. Question number 3. Once I have all of my tool palettes with my productive tools, how do I organize it in a way that it looks much better? And how do I change some properties on my tool palettes? We can organize our tool palette using separators. We left click on a tool palette and choose add separators. We can click and drag it to any position that we like. We can left click and delete it. We can also add text in the same way by left click and select text. Again, we can drag it to any position that we want to. We can also change how our tool palette looks by left click on the mouse and select view options. That is too big for my tool palettes, so I'll change it back. You can change some properties again by left click on the block and use properties. Here we can rotate or ask for rotation when we insert our block. And also we can explode our block. Remember I told you I'll explain you how to explode our block text. We can pick also what layer our block will be inserted. Alright, that was a quick introduction to how to organize your tool palettes so it looks much, much better. Question 4. How do we export, import, and share our tool palettes? We do it by left clicking on our tool palette and pick customize palettes. Here, all you need to worry about is groups and palettes. You can create a new group. In this case, I'll call it the Lazy Arquitecto Tool Palette. Now we can drag any of the palettes to the new group. We need to set current that group. As you can see, now we're using the Lazy Arquitecto tool palette, which only have the elevation palette. In the same way, you can start adding more palettes to your new group. Many people will export the group, but I will say that's a big mistake. Never export groups, always export palettes. In this case, I'll export the palette tools. I'll create a new folder and save it. The reason why you never want to create groups, it's because whenever your AutoCAD crash using the tool palettes, that group will get removed. It looks like it's an AutoCAD glitch, but I always recommend to never export groups and always export palettes. An important step here is always make a backup to your tool palettes. This is very important, and this is one of the secrets to never have a problems with your tool palette. Now that you learn how to export your tool palettes, let's see how do we import them. We do it in the following way. We select our palette, in this case tools, and simply open. Now as you can see, we have new palette and tools, and we only will need to drag it to whatever group that we want. The last step is sharing our tool palette with our team. There is a very important step here. You have to go to options by typing OP and enter, and go to the files. Find tool palettes file locations and add the path for your tool palettes. In this way, whoever wants to use your tool palettes will only need to add that path to their AutoCAD options. I upload videos every Tuesday, so don't forget to like the video, subscribe, and turn the notification bell on. Do not forbid yourself from being part of this community. I'm the Lazy Arquitecto. See you in the next tutorial.